First of all, two or three things. First, thanks for the invitation by Michelle, because I was here because I'm a referent of the Politecnico in the exchange that we got. I want really to do it better in the next time, but really this invitation is really, I'm proud of this. The second thing is just that thank you to come here, because this is the second time that I do something like this in the lunchtime. The first time was 20 years ago at UBC that they proposed me to have the brown pocket lecture. They say, why brown pocket? Right. Because I was thinking it wasn't very much. I was thinking that they gave me money, no. It's perfect. So, because Michelle said to me that I have to talk about landscape and urbanism, really, as she has said on my CV and so on, it's just that really I'm teaching architecture and technology of architecture and really environmental design, but really my focus is always, I love landscape, so I put always landscape. The other thing is just that, first, what I put, this thing here, and this is me, and so on, but she has just done everything, this work, so you know everything about me and so on, but really, more or less, this is me. I've done my master's degree in architecture, studying balloon frame method of construction that was invented by Siegel, that it was Walter Siegel, sorry, that it was an Englishman. This house was just one of the, I discovered that after more or less 25 years that I'm degree, now is really becoming another time a kind of a revival of this method in UK and so on. So really it's something that is always good. And when I teach architectural technology, I try to do with my students some wooden applications. On the other side, it's just that I've done the PhD during this time here, more or less. And I was the first one from Milan to go for a period in Germany, in the Ruhr, at the time in the Dortmund University and the Essen, in the Fachhochschule, really, just to study what they were doing there for the IBA Emscher Park, that is the biggest and brighter examples that there is in Europe about requalification of post-industrial areas, together also with the landscape. Then, this is this. And this was the first publication done, is the first page of the front page, the cover, sorry, of the first catalog that they did, because this thing here still now is not on the internet, was really printed just in books and so on. This thing here that you see now is a beautiful, super public park that is something where you have to go if you go to Duisburg. The other thing is just that, so my PhD thesis was just something that was very, very strange, because you see, in 1996, that means a lot of time ago, I was one of the first talking in a doctorate that is with the specification of architectural technology to say, please mind that also to do landscape means to move a lot of techniques and technology and so on. The other thing is just that we in Italy at the time we were not allowed to do a real project. So they call these things meta project and so on. The only thing, this is a part of Milan where we got a problem. Next year we are here, the Politecnico is the second branch here. But this thing is really in the center of the city, it's called Bovisa. I just was studying to do this and proposal. Oops, why is here this? So, this is this, but then we come back. So, I study about this. The other thing is just that I like to write, so there are a lot of things that I have done. They say to me that most part of them are in Italian, but we know, thanks to God, we are 60 million of people that just speak in Italian. So, the other thing that I like is just teaching. This seems that I'm in a Chinese school, but really this is the Politecnico. We have more or less one third of our students are coming from China now. So for a cause, this is just people there. The other thing, I'm coming from this city. I really would like to invite you to come to Milan, because now it's really, maybe it's not sparkling, but it's really a good city where there is happening a lot of things. We got also, I know that I have to show you the Duomo, so the Cathedral of Milan, but this is the downtown. I discovered with my younger students that when I say I wait for you to go to some visit place and so on, in the downtown they go here and no more to the Duomo. So I discovered when I was alone in Piazza Duomo, in Duomo Square, to wait my students, and they called me and they said, Professor, where are you? We are here. They were there. So this is just because we are very, very international. But we got also these things here that are just new, but look at the Melon, or these things here that I think that maybe you know because it's just also been. She said, no, another time, yes. Yes. They are going everywhere, so be prepared. That is this, or just we got also this one here. That for sure, all the people that is coming from outside of Milan go straight to see Prada Foundation. So, this kind of lecture. I was really terrorized when Michel said to me, this is our program, and so on, because of course, this is okay, this is just, so really, I try to talk about what I'm trying to teach, and really this is just a kind of teaching lecture, something like this. So really, it's just, but maybe it's not canonic because this title, that I put on Google to understand if it really was what I was thinking, is really that I am not a people, a person, an individual, I don't know how to say, that is canonic. I'm always against, really. I grew up, thanks to God, also in my career as an architect, choosing always professor that was not on the edge, but really always criticizing, just trying to say something new and so on. So really, I don't think a lot about what is the past, but I try to look always what is the next thing, if it's possible to say. So more or less, we are talking about this. And then, what happens here. This thing I've seen here, you are very, very manual because you got a lot of things. I mean, you got this beautiful workshop to do real things and so on and so on. Sometimes really in Milan, because we don't have all the space and the whole school is very, very big. It's 10 times the people that is here. So it's just that we cannot have all this effort. So our students are really trying to do everything on the laptop, computer, and so on and so on. And sometimes they forgot that if we have a lack of electricity and so on, thanks to God, our profession is also related to this thing here. The other thing is just that we are in these conditions. I've seen, I don't know how many of you are really coming from China, but you know what is this? No? There's no one here? Oh, brava. So this is cuckoo. The funny thing is that I've seen this thing in the Biennale of Venice, but of art, in the Hungarian pavilion, more or less 12 years ago, and no one of us was just this. Was just written communication as the title of this installation, and I was wondering, why penguins to do communication? I said, well, it's a rabbit, they take pictures. Now I know, I'm almost Chinese, that this is just WeChat, Xianxian, the other thing, and so on. So yeah, this is something that puts together 1 billion of people in China, because I'm almost Chinese, so inside the 1 billion, and the rest of the things, or what's up for us. I noticed that here, the Canadians are just a little bit allergic to WhatsApp. I don't know why. You are always on Messenger, maybe. I'm not on Facebook, this is the problem. So, it's just this, that the communication. But really, this environment like this, I think that you know better than me, that the environment is something that, the landscape, the environment, territory, the land, is nothing, is really natural, because at least one finger, 1 foot, something we have put in any place. It's very, very, sometimes when in this natural science, they say, oh, we have discovered something. Now, I think we have been everywhere. So there are a lot of things that are still very, very well hidden. But more or less, in any place, we cannot say is natural. Also because the other thing is just that we have created. This is, I love stamps, so when I go around the text, try some stamps, the USA stamps are very, very conscious of this, now because even here, this is anthropomorphized, it's possible to say, is just touched by the hand, man of hand. So man can hear, and this is really constructed, no? But so it's always something that we have. And the other thing is just that sometimes we are still creating places that are human or really unhuman or whatever. We have really to study a lot. The other thing is just that the more that I've grown up, I'm still think sometimes that I'm a little baby. So it's just really that I think, not that I confuse it in a very well way, and just to try to put together, I'm very, very lucky when I have an occasion like this to meet people that are not Italian. In my class now, I got more or less 1/3 of Italian, and the others are coming from any place, just because we have to share a lot of things that maybe I don't know, it's just to understand. So it's really a mental, practical to evolve. And at the same time, it's just that I don't know more what is my identity as an architect. It's really something that is more international. It's not the international style of the 50s. It's completely something different, no? So this is Milan, our network. This is, what is this that I don't remember? It's just Shanghai. And so, or just, so more or less. So these things are very, very Yugos, no? So it's just, we are moving in some places, this Seattle, or this is just a new thing that they have done in London now, this is Camden. So, the other thing, sorry if I talk here about architecture, because your work here is doing architecture with landscape, with territory, with urban things and so on. The other thing is, please remember that we are not only working to the things that goes into the reviews. I've just been in Mississauga to see the Met Towers. And so it was funny because I couldn't take any picture like they are in the newspaper, just in the reviews, because I don't know how many Photoshop they've done to do this, because the towers are in the middle of a mess of, can I say, it's just a city that is just very complicated. It's better than this. So it's just that, but they are not there, just like a kind of symbol. Real true, no? So this is just things, retrofit things in Germany. This is just buildings that are just, this is just also a kind of play that I do at home. Can you imagine where are these houses? We do it quickly. This is Norway. It seems very, very, this is Oslo. And this seems really Mediterranean. My students never catch this. So, but it's really, because why in this place they need these kind of things with all the terraces and so on. We spent 1 week in Toronto, we were there. Why they got all the terraces around this house? They're very, very, so it's just, sometimes there are things that are more incredible, just also the use of the color of the city and so on. This is Lisbon. Or just also that really, if you go to Japan, I got this fashion to go there several times, it's just really that not all are just the super architecture that we know, the Wandos, Hijima, and so on. This is the real thing. This is very, very Italian. It's just a kind of super mess that put together thousands of years in a place, and you don't find really published these things are architecture, no? So, or just this, remember, this is something, I don't know if you know this photographer that does these micro models and then he takes the pictures that seems they are more than real, but there are a lot of stupid things now like this. So there's always a kind of joke, really. We are working also not to do this kind of errors. And so, the other thing, maybe because I'm not on the Facebook and anything that is social, only WhatsApp and WeChat to talk with my friends and LINE to talk with the other friends from Japan. So I got three things to be social. And my social side is only on WeChat because really my friends from China, they are in alert if I don't put some pictures of what I do every time. So it's just that. So it's just that. But please don't put always a tag on anything. Just try to suspend this, or just take sometimes the time because we have just to slow down. So things like this. This was Friedrich Kiesler, that if you don't know, was an Austrian guy. He's done only one thing, that is the Museum of the Book that is in Israel, but really he has done a good theory about the evolution of this place. This is just called space definition of planning of the space. So, or just remember that, I mean, we are always, I think that you're better than me because here I think that you're very, very strong in history. I've also talked with some of your teachers that we architects, we got always some hallies that are the philosophers, and we can always find, if we got an idea in the past, in the present, and maybe also the future, we got always a philosopher that is just side by side with us and to force them, or just to get stronger our ideas. No? When I did my PhD, I discovered Anne Jonas, I never left it. This more or less is just the in German, but is the first sentence about sustainability, but before the Brundtland report of the 1987. This is before. So the other thing that I was saying before is just that maybe because I'm Italian, you know, we are always slowed down. We do all the things at the last moment, don't do them very well, but at the last moment. And so really, please go slowly. In our profession, what we have to do, you need a lot of time to digest the things. then you can come out in things like this. And then the other thing that I think that is very, very on fashion, but it's fashion now, is 10 years that I'm saying this thing, also because I'm coming from the magical 60s, so I'm very, very proud of this, but there are two things here that to me are just a kind of super revival now, because really your young generation, you are from the 90s, so really these things are coming maybe in the stories by your parents and so on, so really it's something just like I was listening to the stories of my father, so just my grandfather, so it's something that for you is very, very distant, but they are very, very close also because these people got a lot of inventions in time, you know, Archigram, this thing here, and at the same time, I think in Europe we can, I think that also you, from iTunes it's possible to download the movie, the cartoon movie by the Beatles, where there is Yellow Submarine, that thing, I mean, inside that thing there are these kind of drawings, the only thing is just that now, the only question is about money, but we got all the technologies to do this. So it's just to have money. So but they have fought these things more or less 50 years ago. I don't know if you know this. This is Super Studio. That is just, this was more or less in Italy. We got this. They were very famous for this. So the only thing that now exists about this is just that by Zanotta you can find still the tables that are called quadrata. But on the other side, we're very famous for another picture that was from A to B, that were just two nude people just walking in nowhere. So this is the idea. Or just, this is Hans Online when he was very, very young. That is just the structured potatoes over Vienna in Austria. That was, I don't know how many of you have been to the last Biennale of Architecture. That was in the pavilion of Switzerland. It was that guy that has just carried, that have done another big potato, and he said, thanks to anyone, call us, but he forgot the real potato from the 60s, that was this one. I don't know why, because, so there's a lack of culture, maybe. And all this was something that for us is very, very important, not only because it's something that talks about landscape, because this is Le Parc de la Villette, but really because this is the junction between architecture on one side, landscape on the other, and automatic informations in the middle, because this is just a watermark. But I'm sure that Shumi at the time was using, we call it AutoCAD or just CAD 0.1, 0.05, and so on, because these kind of drawings are perspective, but are not something that is human. It's something that is coming only if you just do elaboration by computer. At the time, the elaboration was so bad that they have just done the redrawing, but I think that is this. The other thing is just that just last week we went just around there to see, I hope that I've written well, so it should be University of Toronto, the Daniel School, the new one that they've just put in the middle of the roundabout. And there was this exhibition that was only written this thing, so I don't know who is the author, nothing. But it was funny because it was just a kind of I don't know, an application of a lot of theories coming from the 60s, right, in Toronto, or something that was invented, so this means here. That is funny because this is very close to the things that we are doing in Milan now, when we have to talk about space, so we are all in. The other thing is just that about education. As students, you have always to be angry on one side, but also don't accept the cookies or the other things and so on. Always try to have a good digestion and say, I like it, I don't like it. The other thing is just that as an architect, remember, you can always say, I like it, I don't like it, before Facebook. I always say, I like it or not. So that's why maybe. And then, of course, there is also fashion that is coming back and so on. This was a drawing of one of my students. This is more or less 2000, so 10 years ago. It was funny because they were coming with these pinky drawings, and one, and then two, and then three, and then four, and then all the course was just doing printings in pinky. At the time, there was just the crisis in Europe of Philippe Rame, that is a guy of my life, my age, that is starting to do this now, especially two colors. They got the blue and the other thing. And now in Milan, we are going to the yellow and blue, if you want to be on fashion. But on the other side, it's funny, because I didn't say, why this pinky? They like the Pink Panther, no. And one said to me, you don't know Ram. I said, I don't know Ram. So go, I spend 60 euros of books to understand why you have to use these kind of things. But on the other side. Oh, what is that? Yeah, so, sorry, this one, yeah. Is this the start? Yeah, but on the rest, So, this is, the resolution is not so bad, but this is something coming back from my PhD, the studies that I've done there in Germany. This is just one of the Grundzug, so it's one of the green corridors that there are in the Ruhr still now, and this is just the things and so on. The red thing that you see here is the route, just to put in connection the things. If you think about a green corridor, maybe you think of something like 20 kilometers and more in Germany, that are very, very experimental, they are also very smart and clever. Sometimes here, this kind of corridor is became just the route, the real street where you can go by bicycle and so on. So they really put this thing as a physical thing, because there were all the signals, the route is here, the route is there, the other route is there, in less than 1 month. So nothing was realized, but at least you got all the routes. So it was very important to the people to understand, wow, something is happening. Then it took 10 years to do this, and really, this is still ongoing, because now there is the program that is for the 2040 go on. What I did when I came back home, I started to study my piece of Milan, and so on, that was a completely mess, a post-industrial mess, where anything was contaminated and not in use, and so on. And we put together, we put together this, I put together this. That is funny, because after 25 years, you see here, this is just the new plan for Milan. That was saying, oh, this place here is green. So I was saying this 25 years ago. And this is Stefano Boeri, the new things that is proposed, that is just everywhere where there are rails, just to become a city like this. But also him has taken some references from this one that is by Francois in France, so that was the first with it. So this is just a picture that you see. This is really Milan, and this is just a work by my students where they have to do really the buildings. So we have done something that is class I, lead gold or something like this, even if it's a tower and so on. But really, they have always, I ask them always, if it's something that is out of the program, to think about landscape, because it's not only architecture. So always to be a kind of relation between the two things, because the other thing is just that in Europe, we got something that is called the Convention on Landscape, that is a law that is for all the states. But really, sometimes it's just that in Italy, we are convinced that this is the landscape, this is historical, this is the landscape, and this is not. But really, the Convention of Landscape, European, that is very, very clever, says that the landscape is the thing that you can see from your window, so you don't have to have a super aesthetical thing and so on. The landscape is everywhere, and you are part of the landscape. You have to work on the landscape. This is Marta Schwarz. The other thing is, and you have to think about infrastructures, because of course it's just an infrastructure have to be something like public. So that's why in Europe it's coming back again, the trams, the lines on the iron. So, or just also, the other thing that we got a lot of problems that are the shrinking cities, where the cities are just abandoning and so on. So this is just what is happening in the south now. The south, you know, the Bauhaus, but the Bauhaus cannot survive. It just became a kind of foundation, no more than this. Really, they got the problem because the people, they were 100,000 before the wall fell down, but now they are expecting to be no more than 40,000 for that year. So what can they do? They can maintain all the buildings and they're just destroying everything and put the grass. Something like this. This is not even not a prairie. It's just you are waiting for the cows, the other things and so on. Something that is low maintenance. On the other side is also that we have a lot of things to be recovered. La Villette another time. This is just 1 month again. Or just, 1 month ago. Or just also, this is always in French, in France, when we got some post-industrial, this is another time, in the case of rails that are no more in use, what happens if you do a new program around? So always a kind of park, the good connections, the other things and so on, and always something that is putting together housing with other things. Because the nature is not only the one written by Gilles Clément that I think that you have, it does natural programs that are really more natural than the natural, so you have always to have this one that is putting pesticides over. Maybe this is more natural, but
landscape is also Versailles, no? So we got all these things, or also these things. This is all we've got. The other thing is here you are really a kind of melting pot of cultures. Remember always this. This is just to say that Carlo Scarpa was influenced because he was one of the first Italians to stay for a lot of time in Japan. He also died in Japan at the end. Or just also another guy, old guy, that is from Seattle, even because he's, at the end was there, that is invented this, just taken another time. A precious idea coming from the Kyoto Gardens. The other thing is just that because you are young, you have to create interferences, because maybe to do something like this that is started by this, that is very, very simple to do, you have to ask to hire 9 engineers specialized in not Euclidean mathematics, otherwise the windows don't come out. And so this or what else? Ah, yes. Oh, sorry. This is the thing. Because this is more or less is my credo, is my faith, because you can put as infrastructure here if you want, but really, if you read the landscape as a territory, as a land really, and so on, we are really talking always about this. We cannot talk about only about architecture, we have always to talk over there. And so, you have just to have a lot of, now this is just advertising, you can learn a lot of things. But if you just consider, because the other thing, yesterday night I thought, oh yes, I do also this one. We got a funny program that is called 18th, nothing to do with the capital of, is an acronym, but really put together 6 universities, very technicians, where the students can come to Milan or vice versa to Paris, other places and so on, for 1 week. It doesn't matter what is the background. So I got always 25, 50 students that are coming, they are all major engineering, civil engineering, any kind of engineering, oil engineering, but not architects, and I send architects to this kind of school and so on. So we have to do a kind of basic course, 1 week, and so on. I invented this. We go around Milan just to see what happens and so on. The funny thing is just that we have done a presentation like this in a congress in for landscape, really. And they said to us, wow, you have done something new, because in 1 week we can explain what is landscape and teach to the students that have never learned nothing about landscape, what could be, and just also to be more concerned about environment in this case. So if these things works, these are, I try to do this. These are the results of this thing, it's just 2 minutes. This is the cathedral, you know.
So all these people that you see here are all. So, that they have done all alone, just taking what they have learned more or less about the city and so on. So this is just all engineers working for us. So really, this is just last words, be brave, be independent. And this. And ta, ta. So that's all. Thanks for your attention first. Then I'm here for all the questions that you want.
Start with one question.
So our first question is, you mentioned that you asked your architecture students to think about how their buildings sit in the landscape. And we often think about this in our school, but more in the urban context. And so I think it's interesting that we ask our students to reach beyond what is traditionally involved in designing buildings. Mm-hmm. And so I'm wondering why you think it's important to teach landscape and urbanism to architecture students.
Because they're just the same, because you cannot work alone. I mean, the only thing I hope is just that I'm more or less more than 20 years that I'm trying to teach that we would like to be the super directors of all the world, but we cannot. At the moment, it's really too selfish, and at the same time, it's just a little bit stupid because we got so many technologies that we have just to put together, even to plant a flower. Just the vertical forest, Bosco Verticale, has 17 patents in this building, because it's not so simple as it is, because it's simple to say, oh, Boeri has just put some plants there. Just to make this plant survive at 120 meters is not so simple. You have to be sure that there are no plants that are coming down, because you know, so on. So there are a lot of things that we cannot only imagine. We have really to search for other, not only consultants, but really people that have always to work with us. So this is the thing that I try to do in all my courses. Not the Politecnico really. One student has always to face with at least three professors that are teaching three things that are more or less coordinated. I'm very, very lucky because he is 20 years now that I got. I can say that I'm the fix and the people is rotating, but every time I found people that is very, very good, that they stay in the class always with me, the 10 hours that we have to do for the workshop, talking with the students, and really let them comprehend that if it's not the idea of architecture that is the winner is just, as you say, is a win-win thing. It's just that all together, because you cannot decide the landscape at the last moment. The totality of, in Italy, of the architects are not a thing, but if you think about Aldo Rossi or Gregotti, they are still super famous, really. They didn't work at all with the landscape and everything and so on. So it's just that if you think really that landscape, that in Italian means is paesaggio and makes something funny also in the meaning, but really that this thing is really the territory. It's just what, where your architecture is going over. So you're going over the landscape. It's not that you are creating the landscape. So there's always to find a kind of connection, and the real well done projects have always this kind of connection. You can feel this. Even if they are, I suggest you to see the projects by Benish Architekten, because there are always these things putting together, and you can feel that the environment is just unique, just the same thing as a whole. I don't know if that's okay?
Yeah. Yeah? Other groups, artists and cultural groups and other things involved in city making and the idea of the place that we want to live in and expanding beyond even architecture and landscape architecture.
Yes, no, this is just, so the thing that I can say is just that because of, okay, just to make a point after back is just that even at the Politecnico, architecture now is going alone. We got the design on the other side and urban planning that is here. And sometimes we don't talk. The funny thing is just that because I got this master, I went to a convention of these people of the landscape, and they did this kind of presentation. I said, oh, they are no more talking about zoning, other things and so on. Really, because they felt that the mission is completely gone. So, in Europe, in Italy, it was just a kind of failure. No one can really do. I do the master in planning for this, and the result could be this. The other thing is just really that we do like here, I think, and so on, a lot of participation when we have to do something, and really by law, but really first was really because the law request that I have to talk with the people, what are the stakeholders, maybe people that could have better ideas than me because are from the place. Now really we are all convinced that really this is the real way to do and the real projects that are working and this. This thing by Boeri that is just this green that is gone forever seems that it's something that is just taken from the earth, just like a bit like this. But really has involved us 1 year of talking with a lot of associations and things and so on. There is an artist that is involved also and so on. So really this overlap continuity or just, I mean, is the new way that we have to work. Maybe it's not new at all, but it's really is the way that I'm convinced that we have to work, whatever we are. I mean, because more or less the recipe is just the same. When I did my PhD, I was traveling UBC, I went to Argentina and other places, and really I was thinking, oh, I found a lot of different recipes. No, the recipe was just one. Maybe the results are just, I mean, you do your kind of pizza, I do my kind of pizza, you do the coffee, someone, the bean is always this, the wet is just the same. So it's just that, but in different situations, the things are changing. Of course, you have to be, at the same time, think very, very global, but at the same time, be very, very local. That doesn't mean to be local, really. We have just to do something better. Then if you, I got a question for you. If you let me know what is the next word in English that can substitute sustainability and resilience, I say to you, thank you so much, because I cannot stand no more resilient and resilience. Yeah, that's also because at the moment it's just a pause or something like this sometimes for a lot of people. Or just is another thing I see my students that they are grown up with milk, biscuits, and sustainability that at the end that they don't know no more what is. It's something that is given as a granted, not something that you have really to maintain and have in mind always.
So you think it's counterproductive? Because it seems like we keep finding ways to divide the ground plane. You have, essentially the ground plane has been divided into landscape, planning, urban design, and urbanism.
But to start the first question? No, I've understood that in the end, so it's just...
The first question would be like, why do we keep dividing the discipline into sub-disciplines?
From the university point of view, I mean, the people that is teaching sometimes is very, very convenient. Because means really just to say that you don't say everything, that you don't know anything, anything is too much. You don't know everything, and you have just to find the connection between a lot of people. It's not so simple to... Sometimes also because if you're just constructing a very good and strong theory, and this is my fault, it's just my thing. It's just that really I don't believe in theories. I just believe in that there are a lot of things that are in motion, you have to keep or take the best things that are around you. So when I do a workshop, other things and so on, or my course, I always call the people that I know that are very, very good, better than me, to explain this. I don't want to do all the work. But there are a lot of people of us teaching and just, that is in the studios, I think the practice, I think that this should be a little bit different sometimes. I think that is clear. I mean, the super big studios in Europe, but I think also here, are really a kind of circus where there are all the people all together just thinking and working on the project. At the university, maybe it's just something that is still to come. Also because, I don't know, the Politecnico, there are still, I don't know if this goes on YouTube, just, there are a lot of people that are thinking that even if the studio project puts together three professors, that one is better than the other. Sometimes they don't call each other professors, it's just that you are my integrator, that seems that you are just, I don't know, something to drink, a kind of hyper lemonade. No, it's just that when I got always colleagues that are working with me for the students. Because to me, it's just that if we don't understand this, you have to let us understand this thing. Because your generation, really, I think that you have always to work together with other people. Even if you are the super best architect in architecture, you know that you need at least other 20 and more specialists in different, and this makes you big and greater.
Would you consider kind of a plaza or a piazza? Italy, there are plazas that have no planting, would that be part of the architecture?
on. Yes, this is a question really for landscape architects. So, and also for people that does super theory. Yeah, the historical piazza in Italy has no plant. Also because we don't use the piazza. How do you think the Italians use the piazza?
Social.
What is the use of the piazza?
Kind of a social academy.
Social? How many people have you seen in Italy in the piazzas when there are the feasts, the other things and so on? But really it's just the market place. Sometimes they're called the Piazza delle Erbe, just because you find the not the groceries, only the vegetables, the other things. Or just military use or other things and so on. Really, we walk always in the border of the piazza. It's very, very difficult that we do something like this. And the other thing is just that we don't stop to talk in the piazza, we go to the bar. So it's something. These things about what, because of course it's just 50 years, more or less, or 20, that really we are self-conscious about what is the use of our places. Because one side is just to see some tourists that are arriving and so on. I mean, people that is coming from the north, that there's just a little warm and they put in the middle of the piazza. For us are barbarians. I mean, if you go around in Italy, even if in the campus, now more or less, but I mean, our students are just started to sit down on the lawn, but just because they are starting before the Chinese, the other people that was coming from any place in Europe, because for us, the grass is there, I'm here. I cannot stand. I need at least a blanket or other thing, or just a picnic thing. So they use the space. We discovered this thing because other cultures now are arriving in Italy, and they use these piazzas in their way. So what I can say is just that we got three parks in Milan that we have never used for 40 years, even if there was the amphitheater, there was, because, you know, in Italy all the people is mandolino and they sing. We don't sing at all, and in public, no, we didn't invent the karaoke. So it's just that, but now we got Arabic mothers with the children, and they go there and they use this space, and thanks to God that we got this space, because they can do community, they share the tea, not the coffee, but the other thing and so on, or also the coffee. Or, on the other side, 20 years ago was just a kind of scandal, because we got the community from Filipinas that they go to the mass, because they are Catholics, they go to the mass, then they stand and they create a great community in Piazza Duomo. And so we said, what they are doing here? They are occupying our piazza, because for us it's to be boys, just I go there, take a picture, I go. So, and the other thing is just the plants. Don't worry, because I got a friend from the Netherlands that is teaching, and said to me, you know, everything is got good in Pienza and also in Siena, but really, in Piazza del Campo, there are no trees. And so really, but it's not, think about the landscape, it's not only about to think trees. There are a lot of things now, there is all these things about mineralizations, other things and so on, but really, there is not a theory that puts together these two things. So it's just it's something that is historical. Because we like the Berceau, the other things, and so on, like in France. Any other question?
Be done.
Thank you so much. Grazie mille.
Thank you.